Welcome to the world of flowers. I'm Jay Schwanke. I've spent my entire life surrounded by flowers. As a fourth generation florist, flowers have been a part of my daily life for as long as I can remember. Now I'm on a mission to share my knowledge and love of flowers with everyone I meet. Growing, picking, arranging, designing, and sharing. It's all fascinating to me because I love flowers. Anything flowers and everything flowers. Welcome to Fun with Flowers and Jay. Today, on Fun with Flowers and Jay, we're gonna revisit my friend Kim Carson. Kim's been on the show several times. We had her on once for a cancer awareness program. And then I featured her as one of my flower friends in my book, Fun with Flowers. We also had Kim on the show to create some single flower arrangements. Whenever I'm around this wonderful lady, it's always inspiring. So I thought it would be a great opportunity for you to know a little bit more about Kim Carson. So Kim, tell us about yourself.
Well, my name is Kim Carson, and I'm on the air at a radio station here in Grand Rapids, Michigan, but I do a lot of different things. I'm a photographer, I'm an author, and also host a inspirational program called Faith, Hope, and Love Songs.
So tell us about Faith, Hope, and Love Songs. That's your deal.
Right. Well, Faith, Hope, and Love Songs, I was trying to get on the air for probably a good 5 or 10 years. And so finally I got it on the air here in Grand Rapids. It's an inspirational show. Right. A lot of people call it a Christian show because I play a lot of Christian artists, but
sure.
It's not any kind of preachy sort of show. It's just a show that you can kind of listen to on a Sunday and maybe get yourself geared up to, you know, hit the work week again on Monday. And that's kind of what the show's all about. I do interviews with artists. I do some of my poetry sometimes on the air, inspirational poetry. And I sometimes talk to people just about what's going on in their life.
So Kim, I know that you love flowers.
Love flowers.
And so today we're gonna make single flower arrangements.
Okay.
You can use containers that you have around the house.
Right.
And you can use a lot of things that you've already got. That's cool. And then if you get one or two flowers, you can place them throughout the house, but
great
you
idea.
Can also give them as gifts.
Yeah.
Because
nice.
I know that that's cool.
I know,
too.
I love it. I love it.
So,
I can't wait.
All right, so our first one, this is a little apothecary jar.
Okay.
And I put some gravel in it from the aquarium. But then we've got our floral nutrient water in there. The cool part about this is it forms a little greenhouse.
Oh, nice.
For it, so it's gonna make the flower last a little bit longer.
Okay.
And for that one,
oh, beautiful.
We got a little David Austin rose. Isn't
that
pretty?
I've never seen that before.
Yeah. We're just gonna cut him short.
Okay.
So and
how
then
short
gonna,
are you thinking?
So I'm thinking that if we cut this guy off, we're gonna cut him off like right there.
Oh, okay.
So he's gonna be short. That stem's gonna sit down inside that thing and it's gonna be easy. So I'm gonna show you how to cut first, okay?
Okay.
Because that's important. We've got our Swiss Army knife, so locking blade knife, which is awesome. And what I do with them is I put them in my hand like this. I always talk about it being a football goalpost. Some people talk about it being a U.
Okay.
So that this knife never comes closer to your thumb. You keep your thumb stationary
smart,
over here.
Smart.
And so then what happens is we put it in between and we just pull back on
excellent.
It because it's nice and sharp. So I'm gonna let you do that up there.
Okay, and you're cutting this way, right?
Yeah.
Shorter?
Yep.
Maybe there?
There's good. Perfect.
That's easy.
That's so easy. So that little guy's gonna sit inside there just like that.
Piece of art.
I know, isn't it pretty? So it's just one flower. And then if we wanted to, you know,
oh,
it could be
it.
Snuck over the top. I like it open and I like this setting off to the side because I think it's very aesthetic. These are for my friends at Euphoria Flowers in California.
Okay.
They're called Sweet Moments.
Oh my gosh.
We talk about them filling the room.
Oh, that smells so good.
Isn't it amazing? And so now again, what I love about this is there's so much fragrance there that you can fill a room.
Mm-hmm.
And so you can put them in several different spots
nice,
in your house.
Yeah.
So we use the shot glasses.
Oh, okay. Oh, wow.
So with these guys, we're just gonna cut those and drop them in the shot glasses.
Okay.
Just see how cute that is.
Oh, it's great.
And then, so you can, and you know what? You can put two in a room, you can put one in the bathroom, you can put one in your bedside stand, you can
people
put one in the
people coming to your house would think that they're like fake, because they're so beautiful.
Oh,
you know?
I know. And then there's the real key is when you get to smell it.
Yeah.
That's the cool part.
A couple years ago, I was diagnosed with colon cancer. And they ended up, you know, taking out about a foot of my colon. And I was at home recovering. And my mom said, Mary, your friend is here, and she's got a bunch of flowers. And so she planted, I think it was 200 or 300 bulbs and perennials, yes.
Wow.
In my backyard, cleared out like all this space, and planted them. And she said, I wanted you to have this garden because next year at this time, when you look out and you see them blooming and they're coming alive and they're living and they're beautiful, you're gonna be able to realize that you too are here for another year. So every year that rolls around, this year is the second year, every year that rolls around and I see the flowers coming up, I'm like, wow, it's another year, you know, and I'm alive too. And so it was a beautiful gift.
So we'll use this guy next, this one right here.
Okay.
And with that one.
Oh, I've never seen that.
How about?
Well, wait a minute, this looks familiar.
Okay.
Have I received this in a bouquet from you?
You might have. These are pincushion protea.
Yes, I did.
Okay,
yeah.
And the pincushions, this is from my friend Mel Resendez in California.
Right.
And this is just, I love this variety because it's got a green center. And then what's cool is, see, this is how it opens up. So when you pull on these, actually what happens is as these start to progress, those little pieces pop out of there. Now this stem is woody. And again, what I find with woody stems is, you know, cutting them with this is kind of, it's a hard thing.
Yeah, it doesn't work.
I've got another little tool here and I'm just gonna, we'll cut it off here.
Okay.
We'll just use a bypass cutter. And then this little guy just gets to float inside there.
Amazing.
There's an ashtray over there.
Right.
Okay, let's work.
I would never think of putting a flower in an ashtray, but let's go for it.
All right. I love this guy because, you know, I'm very much retro.
I
love mid-century stuff. So, and I have two rose stems over there too. Okay, those were just discarded ones that were hanging around, right?
Okay.
So, it's an ashtray. So, it's got a place for you to stick your cigarettes in it, right?
Right.
And then we fill it up with water. Okay, because it's gonna hold water, right?
Yes.
All right. So then, we have a Gerber Daisy.
My favorite.
I know. Look at this guy though.
He's wild looking.
Isn't that wild?
He is wild looking.
With all that stuff. Now, the thing about Gerber Daisies is Gerber Daisies don't like water and they have a very fuzzy stem.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So that fuzzy stem starts to deteriorate very quickly.
Right.
So we don't like it to set in water. So as opposed to this guy, he's real durable. He can set in the water. He's fine. Even our rose floating in the water back there. Gerbera, not so good to float because you'll only get about one day out of it. Okay? If you're floating it. But if you can suspend it, then it's gonna be okay. So in this case then, we're gonna cut that stem short and we're gonna balance it on those.
Where do you come up with
that? So
that
it's just like a little Zen
thing.
That
is beautiful.
It's almost like chopsticks.
This was a book that I wrote when I was in Toledo, Ohio.
Okay.
I guess the basis is it starts out with a story of me meeting somebody that had some kind of connection. I had a connection with them. Mm-hmm. And then I was inspired to write a poem about them when I left, right? Did you want to hear?
Of course I want to hear.
This one, for me, is one of my favorites because it was requested the most. And it's about going after your dream and achieving it. And I wrote this for a guy who wanted to be an actor in LA.
Right.
And his name was Joshua. And so this is called Joshua's September Song. You have a dream, so chase it. A negative thought, erase it. All you seem to want for is yours all along. Stay strong. You have a dream, so live it. Past mistakes, forgive it. Let them go so you can finally see all life's endless possibilities. You have a dream, so be it. And all the world will see it. Growing stronger day by day, setbacks soon will fade away. Always looking forward, never back, will keep your lifelong vision right on track. You have a dream, achieve it. But first you must believe it, and one day, all the world will finally see that you are everything you dreamed you'd be.
Oh, Kim, those are wonderful.
Thank you, Jay.
That's amazing.
Thank you.
I wanted to show you one of the newest flowers that's available. In fact, my friend Robert sent this to me from Kitayama Brothers in California. And they're called rose lilies.
Oh, look at that.
I know. Nature. Isn't that something? It's
that is something.
A lily that has other petals on the inside of it.
That is amazing looking.
And so with this guy then, he can float in this bowl. Now the thing I love about this too is that floating these in the bowl, like that, okay? Yeah. Then I can take these two and they can go into a vase and I'll still let them open up.
Sure.
So then they'll progress and then I have another centerpiece again.
Yeah, a couple of them, wow.
So it just keeps going and going. So, single flowers.
Yes, you can do a lot more than what I thought.
And I know that you're sometimes intimidated.
I am, I'm still intimidated. I'm getting better.
I know.
But I am still intimidated.
And I figured with this was all great ideas. So now you can be magic. You know, you can use two little stems. You got one Gerbera. Yeah. You find a rock with a hole in it.
My brain was ticking as we were doing this.
And the fact that it can be a natural antidepressant.
Yeah, and like I say, you just don't see these. You never see single flowers. I mean, in arrangements, I don't.
Right.
And you always like spend all your flowers when you go out to your garden, you pick all your favorites, put them in a vase, you have them for a week or two, and they're gone. This way you can kind of make it last a long time.
And spread it around the house.
Right.
Spread the love.
Yeah, spread the love.
Well, thanks for coming in.
Thanks, Jay, I love being here with you, you know that.
Oh, it's so awesome, Kim, thank you. So, until next time, keep having fun with flowers.